Hello, everybody, and welcome to Art DJ Productions. And tonight I'm going to be driving the West Highland Line South northbound. And the reason I'm doing this time is because last time I kind of didn't finish the run, I kind of died halfway through. So I'm in my admin chat. I think Callum is sat waiting for me to unmute myself. So, Callum, there he is. Hello.
Hello. I am a Callum.
You are a Callum.
Yes. So, I do many things being a Callum.
You do. So what I'm driving today, as you can see, Callum, is I'm driving the DR number 193, which is a pick and kill 191, clearly.
Very nice.
We've got 97 miles to go. I'm going to try and do it just with this loco. And we're also going to try and do it without crashing, so this could be interesting.
Mm, yeah. Also, Chris is in the chat. Hey, Chris.
Which Chris?
The Chris who made this model.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yes, it is. Hello, Chris. Where's Big Bob? This is the big question on everyone's mind. Anyway, no, this isn't the big question. The big question is, can I get Chris's lovely 191 all the way to Fort William? No, I'm going to suggest. Anyway, without further much ado, let's vacate Helensburgh, which is a really quite rubbish starting place for this route, to be quite honest. I think it would have been better somewhere else, but we're going to try a big load. And we've also, in case anybody is wondering, we've actually got a car de-intender because I thought it had more capacity. So hopefully we'll get all the way with that. So without further ado, let's go.
Also, we are joined by Mr. Christian Rasmussen.
Do we have to be?
I call bullshit.
Ah, okay. Rob. I've got no head code before anyone asks. I need to think of one.
724.
Yeah, no, that's not funny, Chris. So anyway, we're actually going to attempt to get all the way to the other end in time. How good are we?
Mm. That'd be good.
Will you be able to do it, though?
I don't know. I mean, to be fair, I've given myself a pretty heavy load as well. But I thought, well, seeing as this thing's quite powerful, I think we could probably manage like 7 or 8 grampians.
Fair enough.
Although if we stall somewhere, I'm going to blame... I don't know, should we blame Chris? Yeah, we'll blame Chris. We'll blame Chris Wilson.
Yeah, let's blame Chris.
Yeah, why not? Yeah. Be fun.
Thomas Palmer, you watch whatever stream you like.
You can watch every stream in the entire world if you want.
How many trucks did you say you
had? I think 8. Hang on, I count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I thought you said 11. I was gonna be like, damn, that's a heavy load.
Damn, son, where'd you find that?
How long is this?
We have 97 miles to go.
Right, you're fucked.
I don't think so, somehow, Pally. I've got a 6,000-gallon tender.
A what?
6,000-gallon tender. I've got a car de-intender, rather than the one that comes with the pick and go 191. 191.
Hey.
You do you.
That's a big flex, but hey, you do you, man.
I thought this would probably be the best engine for the job anyway, because it's a hill climber.
Yeah, probably.
And plus, it's more interesting to drive steam on these sort of runs.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, better than the electric.
Well, seeing as I can't run electric up here anyway.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. This route is much better suited to steam than electric.
I would say this is true. We're already struggling a little bit.
I like the subtle bit of weathering on the air brake pump.
Yeah, I still haven't fully updated the model yet for the pump to be... But I think it's because I didn't uninstall it before reinstalling it, so... Yeah. A big no-no in Chris, Mr. Wilson's book. Big fat no-no.
Yeah, it was very pretty. Of course, I can match that, Tom, because I've got better graphics now.
Hey! So I keep fucking hearing, Callum. Every day this week, you've been, look at my shiny graphics. I've seen your shiny graphics!
I mean, to be fair, Callum, congratulations, but like...
Welcome. Tone it down.
Yeah, like, welcome to the party, like, years late, and...
To be fair, Chris, though, I was years late as well. Ooh, hello, that's a nice screenie.
You weren't too bad. Besides, think about it this way, Tom. At least our graphics isn't as bad as Anthony. Oh, hi, Anthony.
Don't. I.
Anthony, that is incredibly distracting, by the way. Please stop.
That is really pretty, Tom.
I know. She is a beauty little engine. This is literally probably my favourite Caledonian loco at the moment, until Chris does the 956, which is even bigger. Yeah, well, it's a bigger bastard than this thing, so... I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the 191. I just think it's going to smash all the track up wherever it goes, because it's got such heavy hammer blow.
I would very much like to see a B60.
We very much like to see many things, but unfortunately, people can't build everything all at the time.
That's true. It would be nice to see a Raven B16 in game, though.
It would also be nice to see Callum's face in game.
No, it wouldn't. Wait, Callum, hasn't he said he's planning on doing it?
No, that's a D16. There's a D and a B.
Well, your mum's a B.
Wow, Anthony, that was just rude, but also kind of sexual. Please don't do that again.
Well,
right, I'll...
You need to be less sexual.
I would come down and give you a blowy, but, you know...
Whoa, hang on. So, you're the one who constantly saying to me about how sexually frustrated I am. You're the sexually frustrated one here, boyo.
I think Anthony's had a little bit too much a drink of water, that is.
Probably.
Nah, he's walked past the street with a pub on it. That's why he's acting all intoxicated.
To be fair, it also has a problem with 8-enders.
Stop watching 8-enders.
But, Callum.
Hmm.
Speaking of putting your face in game.
Yeah.
If I just changed the sun's texture to your face.
Oh my god. It'd be like Teletubbies all over again.
Yeah, only more nightmare fuel and more bleach in my eyes.
No. Now we can do our own version of Teletubbies syndrome.
Over the hill, far away.
There's a grenade. Go, oh, hey! So, what's everyone's plan for this weekend?
Go to work, like I always do. And continue to feel ill.
I'm going to work tomorrow.
Right. Question mark?
I'm off on Sunday because I don't work in a pub anymore.
I'm off on Sunday because memes.
I'm gonna clean my car and then go shooting.
What? You're gonna do shoot some blanks?
No, Chris, the schools aren't open on a weekend.
No!
No.
Oh, Jesus.
Tom, we're not shooting blanks, we're shooting real bullets.
You're shooting pigeons?
Yes.
Those fucking pigeons, eh?
Oh, Callum, no, I know exactly what you're going for. No, bad Callum.
Especially given your choice of music lately.
Oh, what, black metal?
Yeah. Let's go with that.
But yeah, no, as I said, I'm going cheering with my dad, and then I'm cleaning my car, and then I'm packing my bags for this cabin trip.
Is this the
one with
pizza?
Your? No, this is the trip you're going on with your boss, isn't it?
Yep.
If we're gonna hear Caleb whisper in the background.
Literally, if that thing comes on the radio while we're driving up, I'm gonna look at it and go, "Hey, this is our song."
Oh yes, JRS Jordan's Railway Simulator pointed out. There goes the not for kids moment. So there we go.
Oh yeah, that's our trademark, isn't it? Our not for kids moment. What a bunch of fucking cunting wankers! There you go.
Fuck shit, wank, bollocks, cunt, ass, whore, Kurt Cobain with a shotgun.
Wait, hang on, how is that not safe for kids?
Kurt Cobain?
Oh,
he
okay.
Shot himself with a shotgun.
Yeah. Why don't we just make a 9/11 joke? Then no one can watch the stream. Then nobody can watch the stream at all because it will be taken down.
Oh, Chris, look, where did you find that gun? Is it just...
Oh, not this again! No, guys, no, we're not doing this again. I thought we've already established that it went through space and time and hit the DR. We're not going to say where it actually hit. Are we, Chris?
Space and time. What do you mean space and time?
Well, you mean you fired it in 1953 or whatever it is, and it hit the DR in 1968.
As I tried to explain to you, mate, that's set in the future.
I don't believe you. I still don't believe you.
So, Aldo, what you're telling us is that the howitzer shell did a Doctor Who, so it went...
Oh no. We had to mention Doctor Pooh, didn't we?
Yeah, okay. Move on. Anyway, so the weather today was quite lovely, Lance.
Wasn't here.
Okay, well...
It was foggy as fuck yesterday here.
In Norway, we couldn't even see anything because it was so shiny.
Well, I mean, good for Norway, I suppose, but, you know, it's not good as eating a pork pie, is it?
Matt Kundrick says, we're just a swearing group of peeps driving trains. Damn.
Fuck yeah, we are.
Damn fucking straight.
Yeah. Damn fucking tooting.
Fuck wank bollock shit bastard. There you go, we're happy now.
I swear to God, if you could make this not safe for kids, I'm going to just go, like, you're joking, right? Like...
I mean, we could literally discuss how cylinders on a steam engine basically equate to breaths, and how injectors and ejectors are basically like penile.
Hey.
What?
Let's not get physical.
Yeah, but hold
let's
on.
Get physical. Physical.
Hold on, Tom.
Hi.
If a steam engine cylinders are breaths, how come they've got cocks on them?
Well, because breaths normally have cocks on them, Callum. He has, he just has it the weird way round.
Weird way round.
Oh shit, does that mean I'm gonna get done in by the LGBT community again?
No. Listen, okay, there's one way to sort this. Callum, don't be so anal about this.
Right, that's it.
I'm gonna say we can get away with this because Callum is indeed a gay man. And we love our friend Callum very much. Except when he's talking about cars. Because then I want to commit suicide.
Or Doctor Who.
Or Doctor Who.
His mouth in general.
I've been all right about cars this past couple of weeks.
But now you mention it.
Now you mention it, of course.
Here's a shut the fuck up, Callum.
Get on an Austin ambassador as well.
Okay.
By the way, to everyone watching, you do realise this will essentially more or less be me in the cab most of the way, right?
Yeah, that's fine.
It's like an actual cab ride, anyway. Hang on, if I go to this view, or this view, no, that one, well, we're just going to get smoke in our eyes, actually, so let's go back to the cab.
We're all just squeezing into the cab, you know, because Chris's fat ass is taking up half of it.
Well, we put Chris in the tender because of how fat he is.
I lost 15 kilograms in a year.
Well, you might need to go find them, then.
Out of 1,000, Chris, come on. You're welcome.
Someone said in the chat, what's wrong with cars? Nothing at all.
Nothing wrong. Oh, actually, no, what's wrong with cars? My car!
Oh, yeah, my car as well.
Everything's wrong with our cars.
Yeah.
My don't even get me started on my car.
Okay. Reel it back.
Don't get me started on my cars.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to take this time to run an ad for my channel.
No, you wouldn't.
I have this voice actor called Tom Dibden.
No, you don't.
There you go.
No, Chris, that's rubbish.
I'm head of PR, I gotta do something.
You meant to say, oh, I just can't wait to strangle Anthony in his sleep.
let me put on my good voice. Oh, I just can't wait to kick Tom's ass.
Oh.
Subscribe to Dark DJ Productions today.
And you'll receive nothing!
Oh,
you lose!
And say the illegal word.
Na-na-na- Oh! That was close.
I was going to say quantum physics.
Oh, wait, that's illegal?
Yes. Because, you see, quantum physics forbid this.
Oh. To be fair, I think any sort of physics forbid me running this engine.
Thomas Palmer, I know what a good car is.
Uh-oh. Help, someone.
No. Anyway, 1969, that's Charger.
Yep, or a 70 Challenger.
Hold on, I need a plug as well. Right, if you want to see what a good car is, subscribe to Greater F*** Circle.
To watch a really bad car get turned into a lump of cheese.
Hang on, time the fuck out, reel this back in a second. I said, time to run an ad, and I run one for Tom. Tom says, oh, I want to get an ad in too. Runs one for himself. Selfish cunt.
That's alright, Round to Refuge is coming soon to Epic Panafted.
Oh yeah, shit, I need to actually work on that.
Uh-huh.
That was fun when we just did 69 Charger and 70 Challenger.
Exactly. And a Mazda 787B.
It's debatable. Anyways.
Oh.
And if you guys want to pester Anthony for another episode of the Foul of Four Refs...
Which I do every day.
Well, I have a very simple answer to that for pestering. Don't.
Anyways, I also have to say that then. If the pestering doesn't work, don't worry. We have the scripts coming to DDJP in 2020.
Oh, yeah.
Zaptor 51, Tom is driving a train.
Am I?
He's driving a Pickerskill 191.
Mm-hmm. And we're not stopping here. We're not stopping anywhere if we can help it.
preferably on the hill. The bottom of the hill.
It's a 37.
There is a 37 and some Mark 2s that look silly.
Oh, lovely dear. We have a 37.
Get rid of our net here. We got a 37.
So, speaking of... I'm looking at something on the screen.
He's looking at Chungus again.
Yes, exactly. I'm just thinking, I've never actually driven this route before. I have it. It was one of the first routes I ever got. But
I got killed by trees. That's it.
Really bad. What? Was it? A friend of mine got me Game of Gnomes. Many furry friends. He bought me Game of Gnomes. And I thought, oh, that's really sweet of you. Never played it.
That's the one with the... Wait, is that the TS add-on with the baby Red 02?
Yeah.
AKA the only drivable 02 we now have left in game.
Yeah, because I never got my hands on it.
Rip Owen.
So if anyone is wondering why I don't have an 02 in Rails of Refuge, I was late to the punch.
You're always late for the fun.
Yeah.
Oh no, I'm just thinking.
And that's why you prematurely ejaculate and I don't.
Actually, Chris, I'm the opposite, but let's not talk about that right now because this is a fucking child-friendly stream.
It fucking isn't. Fuck off.
It's for the fucking families, all right?
Well,
that's incest.
But imagine the scene.
Right? I'd rather not imagine a scene, thank you very much.
Shut the fuck up.
Imagine a scene, right? Little boy walks into a living room.
I don't want to know this.
Right, his dad is smoking a pipe, and he's going, all right, Timmy, you look bored. What's wrong?
Daddy, I don't have anything to watch.
Oh, well, let's just watch this video by Dark DJ Productions.
Dark DJ Productions? What's that?
Well, it is where this man, he drives a train, and he fucking swears a lot to me.
Wow, that's
hey!
Nice, Daddy!
That's fucking fantastic, Dad!
and then you have the American side of the spectrum. There's like, Karen goes walking in. What are you watching, son? Oh, I'm watching this series called The Dark Railway Series on this YouTube that I was advised to not click on because it's 18+. Oh, really? Let me have a listen to it. Oh my God, he said, damn it, I'm suing.
Hooray!
Also, Thomas Popper says, this is England, not Alabama. Right.
Well, actually, to be fair, we're in Scotland right now, but okay.
Right. Well, true story, right? Yesterday, when I was helping Dale with car issues, I was just starting to work when I saw a woman walking ahead while her 4-year-old son was pushing a stroller with a little kid in it, right? She was stuck on her phone. She just turned around and went, are you fucking hurrying up or cunt. I was like, whoa! Welcome to England, where children are mostly born for child benefit.
Exactly. Welcome to Norway, where Callum is mostly born for being Callum.
Yeah.
We're struggling up the bank.
I was the first child, so I was definitely wanted.
Well, saying that, I was the first child. I was probably wanted, but I'm still an accident.
Well, I accidentally killed some people. Does that count?
Yeah.
So your dad basically sat you down one day, Chris. Your son, we always wanted a child, but we didn't want you.
You know, that makes so much more sense.
I think your dad is such a ledge. Like.
Oh yeah, you want me to tell what happened earlier?
Yeah, go on.
Go on.
So, oh my God, just gonna say, Thomas Palmer, Tom, you're struggling with this banking, Chris is banking on a struggling. You're 100% right, and I'll explain why later. Anyways. I'm in my room, right? I'm changing from my work clothes, and my dad knocks on the door, and I'm like, give me a moment, I'm just changing. Fucker still opens the door. Like, I'm standing behind my chair, but, you know, I'm like, I'm changing, and he's like, oh, yeah, I'm just giving you some clothes. All right, fine, whatever. Take the clothes, he's like, oh, and your mother wanted you to come downstairs. All right, cool. He closes the door, and I hear the following conversation. So is he coming downstairs? Yeah, he's just jerking off.
I think your dad is absolutely ledge.
And I kick down the door and I go, hey, fuck off. And yes, my bank account is struggling because I had to pay a 170 quid fine.
What did you do?
Well, technically I didn't do anything wrong.
Well, you did.
Well, you did if you got fined for it.
And 4 points on my license.
Basically, they stopped him. And they realised that there was struggling sounds from the boot. They opened the boot and they found a child in there.
Yeah, I had James Wright in my boot.
That worked so well.
Nah, but like, seriously though.
So, hold on, Chris, were you being an Audi driver?
Yes, because my phone rang, right? So I pick it up from the seat beside me. And I put it back down. Just to make sure it was important. And then I get pulled into the side. He's like, oh, phone while you're driving. I was like,
did you just say you got pulled into the sidings?
Basically, yeah. Pulled to the side.
Yeah, there was a
road. And he just goes, yeah, you've been caught with your phone. I'm like, oh, okay. I checked it. He's like, yeah, but you still touched it. And
yeah.
Like, and he looks at it. Oh, it's still ringing, so he didn't answer it. And I say, no, sir, no, I didn't. And he goes, well, you touched it, so that means you're fine. And I was like, huh, okay. Great.
How many points have you got left on your license?
Four. You can have eight in total. And normally, right, two things. As of 2020, you get points for being caught with your phone. Perfect timing.
Same case here. Been going for a while and nobody adheres to it.
Yeah, but count them. It gets better. Because I've only had my license for about a year and a half, I'm still on a trial license. And in Norway, that means, oh, you got caught doing something. Maybe it wasn't your fault. Maybe it was. Well, guess what? Double punishment.
Yeah.
Basically.
So,
well,
normally I'd get 2 points, but I got four.
Well, I think it's because they're trying to make you learn. It's like with over here, when you get your license, the first year you spend driving, you only have 6 points available on your license. So if you get caught speeding once, for instance, that's it.
Yeah, that's the same here.
You get caught with your phone once, that's again it. You know.
Yeah, but Callum, listen, right? The way the points work here in Norway, right? 22nd of January in 2023, that's when my points go away.
My points will go away this year.
Oh, you have points too. Then look who's judging.
I got 7 points.
All right, well, that's worse than me.
Tom remembers when I got caught driving with no insurance.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I tell you what, it bloody worked because I have not driven without any insurance since.
Yeah, no, I've basically just got my hands free. Like, I got a hands free that actually lets me listen to my speakers.
Yeah. That's why I put a Bluetooth radio in the tool, but mainly because the only times when people ever phone me up is when I'm out of sync, when I'm working, when I'm sleeping, and when I'm driving. Those are the only times that people ring me up. They never ring me up when I'm in signal and free. They never do that.
Yeah. Anyways, we've gone off on a massive tangent. I apologize, Tom.
I've got bigger problems than your tangent.
Uh-oh. Oh, yeah, you're stalling. It's on.
Hello.
You want to not stall?
Well, I'd like it. My boiler pressure went back up. Unfortunately, it sort of decided it's not going to.
Don't.
Hey. All right. Why do I keep calling Anthony Callum nowadays? Is it because he's retarded?
Oh! I see how it is, you asshole.
No, but seriously though, to pull out Callum's legend. Well, actually, no, Callum, your joke is nullified now. We can't say his pressure's gone the way of Oliver Pocock's acting career because he got a role in the latest episode.
Yeah, that's true.
Shit, chuckle Thomas.
I'm just thinking, is this another one of Chris's Caledonian products where it's set up where you go half reg, half reverser?
No,
not. This is his last one, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, Callum, he stopped doing that a while back, I think.
Oh, okay. I'm pretty sure that it's what was the last engine with that then?
The one that was the last one with it.
Wow, really, Chris?
Yeah, I'm helpful. Yeah, Tom, I hate to be that guy, but I think 7 coaches might have been too much.
What's the hill?
1 in 54.
1 in 54. That's fairly steep. But I kind of like what you said earlier. I chose this engine, climb hills.
Are you going to hold that against me now?
No.
I'm not gonna because I'm not an asshole.
I thought you were gonna say I'm not gonna because I'm a Nazi. I'm going, what?
I mean, I do have the rank ZSS, but like, let's not get into that. That was Anthony's idea.
Yeah, because, you know, Chris, the idea was that I was the bad cop, you were the not so.
But then I snapped. Then I snapped at someone and I became the SS as well.
No. Anthony's the incompetent cop. Chris is the Nazi cop.
And you're just not here whenever something like this happens.
I'm the gay cop. Oh, he looks so guilty. I might drop the charges if you drop your pants.
Callum! I'm trying to concentrate on Tom fucking stalling here.
What happens if you go... Oh, wait, no, because you've already said you're trying to build up your boiler pressure. What's the blow-off on it?
Oh, I'm on. I've got full blow-on.
No, what's the full working pressure?
180 on, I think.
Oofed.
Jesus Christ, this area is so fucking massive.
Stupid question, Tom, but have you got your handbrake?
No.
If you had, it would be hilarious.
Well, not for Tom, it wouldn't, but for us, hell. Anthony, are you drunk?
Maybe. Don't.
Oh my god, Anthony's had a drink of Dr. Pepper, but that's probably as close as he's going to get to alcohol.
Well, to be fair, Callum, considering at the moment I've been spending the last 3 months stuck in a bar. Are doing, like, work for money.
Yeah, true.
So you just get really tipsy just by being there.
Now all I do is get proper miserable there.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, that's what it's like working in a pub. I should know.
Well, that's the thing, is when you're not even on, like, serving you, it's literally less, like, the timeballs on the manager, man.
You're speeding up, Tom.
Yeah, I know, because my boiler pressure is slowly going back up.
Yeah.
Callum? Is he?
Yes, he is. Look.
Wow. That is amazing.
Wow, Chris, your sarcasm is so...
God, fabulous.
I wasn't being sarcastic, I was actually surprised. Alright, so county 2.
There you go. How long does the hill last? Does it last a while?
I bloody know.
calling back to a few moments ago. Yeah, guys, most of this run is going to be in the cab.
Alright, fine. Back to the cab we go then.
No,
gonna
no,
be
no,
like
no.
That. Bitch!
I had been transported back into the... Well, never mind. Back to the story.
Chris had transformed into a giant...
Why is there sparks, engine sparks out of the funnel? It's simple, because he's applying so much pressure in the funnel that it's literally like you let a massive one rip and something comes out.
Oh, Chris!
What?
That's disgusting!
Oh, you love it.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
I'm actually really strict on that. No, I don't. So basically, the engine is just having a giant shart.
Yes. Congratulations. What has been seen cannot be unseen. of the Aberdare Zapper, I think it looks pretty nice. And seeing as I've seen some footage of it actually running, it actually looks pretty amazing.
My thoughts on this, the model itself looks nice, but the engine itself is, like, ugly.
Yeah,
it's basically a city body. No, it's because it's a city body, like, sat on a really ugly squash chassis.
Yeah, but that's because you have no taste.
Don't rub it in, Chris. It's not my fault I was born without taste buds.
I've, with me and the Aberdares, I mean, I kind of like them for what they are. Well, were, rather. And I do like Chris's model. It's probably not one I'm going to rush out and buy myself, because to me, I like Great Western, like certain Great Western engines, but I feel like I've had my fill.
Did not just drop some coaching, by the way. No one saw that.
No, I didn't.
No, I
didn't see that at all.
So
if I want to get to Fort William by the end of the night, I need to drop some coaches.
Also, someone is saying that compared to you, Tom, I am very quiet.
Yeah, because you're very quiet on my end.
Well, why don't you fucking fix it?
You're not that quiet on mine.
Yeah, but that's because you've had me turned up all the way because I'm your senpai.
Oh. Is my volume all wrong?
No.
Yeah, because I can't hear you at all.
Oh!
I'm joking. Yeah, you're good.
Oh, there we go. Hey, 10 miles an hour.
Hooray, Kreutzer.
Do you
ever know thought with an engine that's as beefy as this, it should be all right with going up hills?
To be fair, I did give it, like, 7 grampians.
Yeah. That's a lot of rolling resistance.
Hmm.
Chop, 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 chop.
Snow, we should handle 10 grandpas with ease.
Hmm.
What's a Percy?
What's the question?
What's a blowjob?
Is that a diesel? How disgusting.
The fuck, Anthony?
Previously on the Troll and Island Railway Sketches, I learned how to divide by zero. Really?
Boo.
It wasn't me, Tom. It was the magic country.
No! Don't you dare even make that reference.
We could have ruled together, Nick, as slave and master. But no, you had to talk.
Wait. What we had was special. You were the only slave I ever had.
What are you on about? I was never your slave.
Tom was coughing his ass off.
What the hell just happened? I don't know. Shut up, Nick. Oh. I am going to murder the next person who says, Nick!
Shut up and clean your room!
Yes,
from the glory days.
Stainless steel case. Awesome.
Yay, we're doing 22 miles an hour.
24, 20, fuck, I'm done, we're speeding!
Chuffity chuff, chuffity chuff, chuffity chuff. Has the hill leveled out yet, Tom?
Yeah, to one in 171.
Oh, there you go then.
I'm going back for them coaches and get stuffed. They'll just have to walk to the next station, won't they?
Where's our train? Why has it left us behind? Because you're all fat and you're slowing us down on the hill.
You're all fat, you need exercise.
you're all exercise, you need fat.
One morning, Percy was fat the next day. Granny Dryden had made cocaine for Pat's birthday.
I'll keep you dry in the winter.
Would you like a nice cup of tea?
Terrible! I still haven't driven this route.
My impressions of this route so far is that it's very tree.
It is very much tree.
Yeah, there is a lot of wood in this route.
Callum was very excited. He couldn't wait to sit on all the trees if he got cast by drift.
Oh, well. Well, Chris, just well. Well, wagon.
Callum.
Hmm.
Looking Bantasaurus.
Bantisaurus.
Oh, are you kidding me?
What?
They don't have that emoji. That's sad.
Aww. Yeah, but what if I told you that you were an emoji?
Yeah, exactly, Chris.
Yeah, that's alright.
Fucking get wrecked. Pylon!
You must construct additional pylons.
Oh my god, electricity.
What is electricity?
That's quite shocking.
Oh my god, funny.
Chris, just...
I can tell Calum's kind of upset.
You know what, Chris, right? Don't work for Samaritans.
What?
What?
You know Samaritans. They're a lot like, you know, when you're having issues, you phone them up and they basically give you a little bit of counselling over the phone. They're generally the organisation that people turn to when they're about to end it all.
So to speak.
Yeah. I imagine that if Chris was on work for Samaritans, then the population of the world would drop by about 2/3.
Are we seriously doing, like, you know, suicide jokes in there, dude?
I don't want to.
Well, you just did, so I'm going to have to make my own suicide joke now. Uh-oh. Ready? I'm not actually going to do it. I'm just saying it just to make you feel bad.
Oh, I mean, he deserves it. Anyways, 1738.
What about it?
I don't fucking know. I just wanted to say something random to get us on topic again.
It's still 1738. It's 1910.
My train's going chuff.
Whoa! Does it, Chom? Did you really go chuff?
It does. So,
what happened the last time you tried this run?
I kind of let 37, I think it was, or 450, whatever it was, I let it go down a hill and it just sort of derailed.
It went da-da-na-na-na-na-na-na.
So, in other words, you pulled the Dark DJ on it.
No.
You pulled an Epic Banassa on it.
I pulled some females on it. Yeah, I'll do.
You pulled
a Fenton on it. You just started running downhill. You're like, Fenton!
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Fenton!
Nice greening.
That reminds me.
There's always something to remind me. Sorry.
I just gotta test this route out.
Go on, Em.
Okay, I've done it. It's Chris Central, by the way.
Da 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 da. Chuff.
Memes.
Oh, hello. I now have border pressure.
Whey.
Also, I think I'm approaching. Oh, yeah, I'm approaching a loop.
Also, you've overfilled with your wall.
Gather that.
Really? How? How can you tell? Rainbows.
Wait, are we going through Dan Douglas? No, Glenn Douglas.
We've just gone through Glenn Douglas, yeah.
Yeah.
Glenn Douglas.
Shame we don't actually have Glenn Douglas in game.
Shut up! Stop being Callum. Be someone else. Be John.
Be John.
Yeah.
Not BJ. Be John.
The problem is that I live in John Central. Like every other person here is called John.
Exactly. Okay. You're the perfect man for the job. Man, I say.
Like whenever I'm doing my rounds in the van, I come back and my manifest is just signature say John. It's just like wow. I mean, people have been very creative with names. What do we call our child? I don't know. What's the most popular name around here? John. Let's just call him John. Fuck it, be done with
John.
Yeah, let's call the child John. But he's a girl. He's called John.
Well, you know what. Imagine if you had a child called John and it was senile.
John Senile.
Da-da-da. Wait, what can't they do?
They do though, don't they though? Ooh, there's a hill.
We are now on a downhill bit, right?
Downhill. The hill.
This is a section of the journey where we could save some water, at least.
Mm. That said, you've still got over 5,000 gallons.
Yeah, but I've also still got 82 miles to go.
I was about to ask how much longer you got. I think you might be all right, because that run I've done with the A2 running from London to Peterborough at full pelt... let's see. They have 5,000 gallons of the and that thing is thirsty.
Tell you what, the problem is because of the time of day of running it, you can't actually see all this lovely scenery out here.
Rip.
Ripping pepperonis.
Did you set it up early in the morning, or...?
Yeah, it is currently 7:53 on an autumn day. And it's also currently eating bananas.
Pretty pretty. I imagine it's going to get brighter as
Oh yeah, it'll get brighter as we go along.
Yeah.
Not as bright as the Brighton main line though, boys.
Well, bright is in the name.
Problem is, I go on this side, I can't see the bloody F4, F5. And I kind of need that. Sorry, I've got a cough.
That's fine. So is Alex. I can hear him hacking away up there.
What's he hacking?
his lungs up, I think.
Oh, so he's not hacking the CIA?
Nah.
No, that's my job.
What?
You see, I,
Wow.
Wow.
Do you know what? Just because of that, I'm going to have another drink of milk.
You need some milk.
Just because of that.
Milk is all I can drink at the moment. I keep getting sick with everything else.
It's his job, Palmer. Calm down.
Whose job?
Callum's driving a van. He's not a pedo like James.
Wait, really? I say that I drive a van and everybody's on the pedo. What the fuck?
Yeah, that's not what you... That's what we call the car, isn't it? The pedo wagon.
My cars are passion wagons, I think you'll find.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow.
I'll have no nagging of a passion wagon.
Oh, my.
Problem is, this is a route that's really more suitable for a diesel. But, I decided I wanted to drive a chuff-chuff.
Yeah.
Why would you do that?
What, drive chuff-chuff? Well, Chris, let me explain a thing or two. They go chuff.
Train.
Yeah, shit.
Trains do go chuff. I can attest to this.
Can you?
I couldn't believe it when I found out, though.
Ah, no. Oh, you know, but if we're talking diesels for this route, class 26 or 27.
Yeah.
Oh.
We need need better ones, because I've just put the IHH one down as, like, random Bond logos.
Yeah. I'd much rather... if we had one with proper sounds, it didn't sound like a brick in a washing machine. And also, the issue that I remember having with the IHH Class 26 is that the wheels aren't centre.
And that the wheels on the bus do not indeed go round and round like we thought.
There is a question in the chat, and I don't know if you have answered this before, Tom, but I'm going to make you answer it again.
Aww.
What's your favourite GWR logo?
Choo Choo.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
His favourite Great Western engine.
You'd ever dare.
Well, as much as I'm looking forward to giving that thing a go, it's definitely not the best looking of the Great Western logos. It's interesting. It's interesting, but not good looking. Then again, if Chris built one of the Krugers, holy shit, that thing was ugly.
The only thing, the reason I said that is because he's put up a new image of it. He's doing the livery variants now, it looks like.
Ooh, woo.
I saw the one with the black frames. I quite like that.
That's just racism there.
He's done the unlined Great Western with black frames.
Oh.
Looks nice though. I like it with the black frames. I prefer it out. Because to me, green and red don't really go well together. To me, anyway.
Looks away and sad. Yeah, for those of you who actually wanted to get an answer for Tom, apologies, but he's Tom.
Oh, right. You actually wanted the actual answer on what my favourite Great Western is?
There was someone who actually asked the question, yeah.
Okay, 2884.
Okay, fair enough.
Callum, I got a noot-noot.
Noot-noot.
Yeah, Callum's special. He likes the sound noot-noot.
I love the noot-noot.
You did not help the case there.
How many times have I streamed in the Discord chat and I've been driving Cali Loco and I've been going, give me noot noot, give me noot noot. Just go for every single bee whistle until I get noot noot.
Are you getting just like, noot noot?
Noot noot noot!
The noot noot is my favourite whistle.
Do you know what the really irritating thing is, right? The car D-Intender actually really suits this thing.
It does.
Ta-da, you have a new tender for it.
What?
It's not inaccurate, it's a Cali tender.
Yeah, but still kind of inaccurate.
You know what kind of reminds me of? It reminds me of when the schools classes used to use Lord Nelson tenders.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
That's for the Lord Nelson, the schools that were based on the Western section.
Mm.
Yeah, can. Chris, whatever your name is.
I have a question for you.
Oh no, you're turning into Jinty, aren't you?
No, Christ, no. But I was gonna say, mate.
No.
If it had been out back then, would you have put a 2884 or 2800 on the DR?
Yes!
And would it change, like, which character would it remove?
Colossus, probably.
Okay, because I was thinking, like, you change out Hannah to be a 2884 or something like
that. Actually, that would be amazing. It's just like, Dave's just like, oh, look at my new girlfriend. All right, lads.
Yo, what's up, motherfucker?
Right, so hold on. If you have a 2884 in TDRS as Dave's girlfriend, it's going to sound like a diesel dyke.
Maybe. I don't fucking know.
All right, lads. What you think of my body? Beautiful, feminine, innit?
Well.
Yeah, your ears don't exist, Saptor. Welcome to the family of not having ears. Residence Callum. I'm driving the Dub D, can't you see?
Well, no, because I'm driving a Cali Loco. Can't you see?
No.
Here's the thing,
I'm driving the Dub D, can't you see?
If a Dub D was a character, I could imagine it sounding like Windsor Davies from In Half Hot Mum. So, sort of militaristic in nature.
All right, lads. We're going to go over the beach now.
Can I just point out this means nothing at all? Like, I get sick of this. I keep saying this at work. I don't understand any of these references because I don't watch any popular culture stuff, so I have no idea what anybody's saying half the time.
Yeah. Basically, Pomp the hipster, he likes to watch niche things.
I watch very niche things, like, you know, for example, what culture? That's literally about it.
Tom.
Hello.
Your taste in culture and shows is the same as Callum's taste in cars.
Oh dear, that makes me feel really bad.
Oh, thanks.
By the way, right? Do you guys remember in the past me saying about the DR basically being all in forest?
Yeah.
Right. At least my forest isn't this close to the fucking line.
I can't see anything.
I can't see. Oh, oh bloody hell! I just gave myself some sort of headache there. Anyway.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, what?
Let's play I Spy. Oh god, not this again.
Oh, let's play this game. Alright then, I Spy might look like someone giving me fucking trees!
Oh, I know. Is it a tree?
No. Oh. It's a fucking tree. I also found something else beginning with F and called a fucking embankment.
Oh shit.
And a fucking bridge. Oh, fucking hills, fucking everything, fucking fuck.
Well, in that case, Tom, can you see the couple fucking between the three trees?
Oh, why fuck me, so there was. Anyway.
Well, I think we've just found some new dialogue for Abomination and Andy in the future.
I buy with my little eyes something beginning with death.
Beginning with fucking quarries.
Abomination, we've been playing a game for 2 months now. I already know the answer is rocks.
To be fair, are they still sat in the opener, or have they gone into the shed for some sexy times?
I don't fucking know, I ain't been up there.
Some sexy times.
Oh,
yeah, cool, because I imagine, like, Andy being, like, Andy sort of being... Wait, hang on, who's older, Andy or Abomination?
Abomination.
Is he? No, he's not.
Hold
no!
On. Right, I'm Abomination, firing up the
other. Abomination was built in 1964, so when was Andy built?
1963.
What, Anthony?
Three, so Andy's older. Abomination, even with all these new diesels coming in, he's still the baby of the group.
Oh!
Hold on, what is,
Until Andy... Rick turns up, anyway. 7070, D7070.
You idiot, Callum.
Until Rick comes along, it's like, Rick is going to be the biggest fucking hench intention on the line, yet he's going to be the baby.
Hi, my name's Rick.
1963. Hey.
Yeah, so he's only a year, he's literally a year older than Abomination, so he can't even pedo on him.
Oh. Wait, time out. Hang on.
What?
Are you okay there?
No. Chris, help me. I think I might be dying.
Imagine Lena with Abomination.
Oh my god.
Right, I'm curious now. If I can.
Oh my god, I'm so sick of hearing that word as well. Oh, I'm curious about something. Shut up!
Go on, let Anthony talk.
I have a question.
Go on, Anthony, what's your question?
I'm curious
about. Right, that's it! Die! Right,
you weren't stuck in a call with that for 2 hours yesterday.
Well, I'm sorry, you could have left the fucking call! Me, fuck off! You've just been mean by saying on stream.
Well, tough, that means we're rebels.
Rebel, I want you in my ass.
Anyway. I've just found out that Warrior was built March 1963 as well. He's a few days younger than Andy, I think. Because Andy was outshot on the 8th, was it?
Oh. Callum, you're reading slightly too far into this. I like it. Carry on.
Yeah. So, right. Andy was outshot on the 8th of March 1963. And then Warrior was outshot the 15th of March 1963. So.
Was he?
Yeah.
But did he eat a cupcake?
What Warrior is Andy's little cousin.
Oh.
Well, not really, because they weren't built on the same plate, were they?
And then we've got Clyde. When was Clyde? 1960. No, 1962.
It was a great loss. Hang on, let me just shit on all of you. 1955, bitches.
Let me just shit on all of you. 1891, bitch.
Shut up, Lino.
That was Fear and Otto. Oh, Lino was built in. No, wait. No, Fear and Otto were built in 1893. Lino was built in 1890.
Yeah.
And Lino Abomination is numbered about the year the railway was actually founded.
Jordan, can you ask me that again? But can you spell my name properly this time?
Wait, who are you?
Isn't it with a K?
It's not with a K. It's with
Wait,
a
your
C.
name is your name isn't with a K?
No.
Oh my god.
Oh fuck, we've been getting it wrong all this time.
What?
No, but Callum, seriously, I feel you because everyone called me like spelled my name with a K in school.
I wonder how many people talk to you, Chris, and think that you're Chris Wilson.
I'm pretty sure Chris Wilson does not sound Norwegian or is a massive cunt.
Oh my god, no, hang on. Hang on a fucking minute. No, I can't let this slide. Tom, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
Bus was built in 1950?
Yeah.
And I'm trying to fuck him?
Well, ladies and gentlemen out there, we have just heard a confession from Mr. B. He actually wants to fuck Buzz.
Hold on, what?
All I'm saying.
What's Mr. B's number?
Oh, he was built in 55, Callum. I already know.
Right. So hold on. Wait. Hold the bus.
Why do you think I said 1955, bitches?
Let's think of it this way, though. Buzz is older than Barry.
Wow.
So, you know, I was built many years ago. Oh, Barry, when were you built?
Very old. I think your vine I was built in the year 1752.
But Barry, that's...
Shut up.
Oh, shut up.
Right, so, hold on. Hold the bus.
We're seeing some nice scenery now, by the way, Callum. Look, the forest is fucked off.
Let Callum speak. Hey,
forest?
Yes?
Fuck off.
Okay.
Go on, Callum, what was you going to say? Apart from...
Right, so... So, with Mr. B and Buzz, we ended up with reverse paedophilia.
Apparently.
Oh my god, you're right. And...
Remember, they're both... No, hang on, no, they wouldn't be.
Just saying, right?
Mr. B just turns up just like, hey, yeah, Mr. B, Buzz, I'm going to get
18.
You
convicted. He's at least 18.
No, is he though? No, is he?
Do you know what? I think consent works differently with inanimate objects.
Oh, yeah, you're right. They're inanimate. I forgot. But hang on. No, because we're in...
Wait, technically. No, wait. No. They're sentient objects, not inanimate.
Yeah. But, Tom, are we in 75 now?
No, we're in 2020, you fucking idiot.
fucking funny. I'm gonna fucking kill Clark now.
Go for it. I welcome no, death. We're in 1970 fucking five.
Yeah, thank you. So that would mean that but Mr. B is 20.
Hmm.
And Buzz is 25.
Well, that's a bit of quinky dink, isn't it?
My characters are 12.
Well, come on, Caleb. How awkward is it going to be for me when I'm voicing a zero-year-old?
Oh, yeah.
Wait, I've just got to think of a name. Oh, yeah. Chris Wilson gets on with Rick.
I'm being nice.
I'm being nice. I'm only joking. Get on with it. Anyway. I'm only joking. Get on with it.
Good evening.
Good evening. When Tom and Dibden asked me to build a train, I told him to fuck off. Then it offered him and then it offered his silence. I said, I'm not a man who can be bought. Then he offered me more silence. Good evening. No, I'm joking. Chris is busy with all his stuff, so it's fine. Oh my god, there's a station coming up! Woohoo! Let's slow down.
Oh.
That's great. Quick
question though, Tom.
Answer though, Chris.
Is it going to be stationary?
I don't think we are going to be stationary at the station, you know? Well, wait, is that where the word station comes from then? Stationary? Oh my
really?
God! Have I really just worked that
really?
Out? Have I
are
only.
You
oh my god!
Oh my god, I'm surrounded by idiots. Are you fucking kidding me, Tom? Are you. No, no.
I legitimately just thought of that. Is that why it's called the station? Because
all jokes aside, are you fucking serious?
I am being fucking serious right now. I did not know that what it meant.
Tom, you gave me shit for not knowing what MT fucking P and F meant.
PNF, what's PNF?
Huh?
PNF, what the fuck's PNF?
P and.
Oh, right, I get you, okay. No, it's just a thought, like, I didn't even think about it. I was just like, is a station called a station because it's where you're stationary?
Yes! You moron! This is the guy who built railway lines in game. Stations, like almost on par with Andy on his one route.
Which we won't talk about because of Guillaume.
Yeah, and he still didn't know that. Ladies and gentlemen, Tom is special.
Confirmed. I'm not even going to deny it. I find it fucking hilarious. I find something else hilarious, but I can't talk about it at the moment.
So, oh, yeah. Yeah, no. I feel you, mate. I get you.
Yeah.
Anyway, Chris, what does PNF stand for? Piss and fellatio?
Probably.
No, it stands for...
penis and valgear, doesn't it?
No.
PVG.
Pedophilia and fingering.
Oh! Oh. I'm not sure I want to think about it at this
Ladies
point.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are no longer child-friendly.
We never were.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes, we should add our disclaimer. This is not a fucking child-friendly live, right?
We've already done this, though.
No, but we need another disclaimer just to make sure. Right, so if you're a parent, right, and you're letting your four-year-old watch this, right, frankly, social
Go services... Go fuck yourself.
They need to come round and steal all your biscuits, right, and while they're at it, they'll steal your child, because that's what's happening there. Did I get social services right? They do come and steal your biscuits, don't they? Anyway, Callum made it awkward for everybody. That's what I'm good at. I am good at drawing, driving, and making shit awkward, and being sexy. Those are the things I'm good at.
Do I sound bullshit? Because I could sworn he just said being sexy, and we all know that's not true.
I am sexy!
Well, about that.
Yeah, maybe in your furry world with your fursona, you drew it to be sexy, but everyone can dream, Callum.
I never actually draw persona to be sexy.
No, but we don't want to see it either.
Trust me, we've seen enough of it. Anyways.
I'm so sexy, I can't get it.
Speaking of bananas.
In pajamas.
How is Callum today?
Driving a train.
Well, I was driving a train earlier. But then, I thought I'll save driving a V2 back down to King's
Cross. Oh, guys, we've still got 70 fucking miles to go.
Ooh.
Mm.
And the trees are back.
I know.
I find that very intriguing.
Oh, my God.
Oh, fuck off, Chris. Chris, shut the fuck up or I'm coming round your house and stealing all your biscuits.
It's not the point where I tell him I don't have any biscuits.
I'll find biscuits. I'll just be like, ha! Chris, you told me there was no biscuits. What's this? Rat poison pellet? Well, I don't care. I'm going to eat it anyway.
Go on, then. Fucking, you won't.
Wait, I literally just lost the conversation. What are you on about?
Banana boats. Anyway, so when it comes to hilarious things,
mm-hmm.
not the thing that me and Tom are thinking of, but when it comes to hilarious things, can we all just agree that it's absolutely hilarious that there's a stain on the steam pump?
I like the stain on the steam pump.
Me too.
I noticed that when Tom started streaming.
Yeah, I like it as well. It gives it a bit of character.
Exactly.
That's a characteristic stain. Because obviously, I mean, it's a mechanical component. There's going to be oil in it, and it's bound to seep out a little bit.
I mean, that just sounds disgusting, though.
I absolutely just fucked up.
What have you done, Chris?
So I was fiddling with a pair of pliers.
Yeah.
And they kind of did that. Only the first time, I need to go grab a band-aid real quick.
Chris, why do you keep injuring yourself? Better God, if it's not your knives, it's a pair of bloody pliers.
I mean, to be fair, if you look at my arm, right, because of my work, and because I work in cramped spaces with a lot of sharp objects, I get so many cuts every day just from doing nothing.
I'm just wondering how long it's going to be until he said, guys, I had an accident. What did you do, Chris? Well, my ears were clogged, so I thought I'd try using my my pocket knife to clean out my ears.
What's wrong with that? I do that every day.
Yeah, but in the process, instead, he cut off his right leg.
I cut off Callum's eyebrows.
What eyebrows?
Are you that shit at cleaning your ears with the knife? That you're not cutting my eyebrow. Your knife just ends up all the way over in fucking Shropshire, and then like a boomerang, it comes straight back to you in your hand, and you go, I'll never get my ears clean.
No.
Then I'm just on a call like, Chris, did you try cleaning your ears again? Now I look like a fucking alien.
I mean, what do you mean look like you are?
Oh, wow, that was rude. Thought I'd grab the cab for a little bit. What? What do you want? What?
Chris is being nasty to me. He's being a mean piece of poo.
Good.
Okay.
Oh, that's not very nice.
Okay.
Ooh, that's a nice bridge. I like it when there's routes with nice assets. Are we still going downhill, Tom?
No, we're climbing now.
Yeah.
Oh, Tom?
What?
Is the line doing the same as my life? We're going downhill.
Yeah, maybe.
You never know, Chris's boss might be watching. Hi, Chris's boss.
I don't think Chris's boss will be watching this. More than likely. Oh! Is it your pills? Does it feel like we're going faster in the cab?
Yes.
Yeah, I think it's because the whole world's coming towards you.
Is it though?
I think that's what it is. It's a lovely looking chaff chaff, man.
I know, that's what I meant. I love the fucking 191. This route, though, I'm not so sure I like it as much as I did when I first tried it. Mainly because it's full of forests!
It's full of fucking trees!
Exactly. And memes.
Memes?
Memes.
Memes?
My bank account after there's a sale on Steam. I shall initiate self-destruct.
Oh shit, now you talked about bank accounts. I forgot I haven't paid my rent today yet.
Well,
sort that out quickly.
Chris is gay. Oh, sorry, I just thought you had. I had to mention that.
Well, I kind of already knew.
Oh? But you didn't?
Speaking of bananas, I think I left one in my car. I'll fix it tomorrow.
Speaking of chungus.
Wait, chungus.
Make my way downtown, eat my ass, big one.
Oh. Right, that's me transferred my rent money over. Oh, yeah. Okay. Right. Send that to landlord.
What?
Well, you know how my dad's apparently a legend, right?
Yeah.
Apparently.
He just sent me something. The pilot forgot to turn the PA system off and told the co-pilot, "Man, I could really do with a blowjob and a coffee." So the air hostess ran towards the cockpit to warn the pilot, and someone yelled, "Don't forget the coffee." I like how Callum doesn't get it because he's, you know, killing me.
That's very discriminatory of you, Chris.
Who cares? I don't discriminate. I hate everyone equally.
Same.
Right, now my rent's paid. I've got £50 to do me for food and a couple of other little bits until the end of the month. Woohoo!
Nice.
I want to grab a drinky dink.
I want to fish.
But you all had the same answer. Engines don't go shish.
Silly sticking the muds, sticking the muds.
I'll show them.
I want to be a porn star. The engines all had the same answer. Enne.
I love those poops.
Yeah. I think the Hour of Poops are perhaps the best poops I've seen. Because it sort of go one step further, I think.
Oh, thank God.
Cornetto. Oh, hello. What's that doing in there?
Ooh, what so whoa?
Ooh, who was this?
If you saw it to your essay, what would be the first little cube put on the screen? Dab.
Yeah, Dave.
It will always be down.
Yeah, because... Well, no, technically, no. No, Tom did say that he would replace him with a Royal Scot.
Wait, what are you on about? Sorry?
Zapter51 asks, if you started TDRS today, what would be the first locomotive you would put on screen?
Don't know.
Probably Dave.
Oh, that or Theo.
Fair enough.
I've just found a pebble in my shoe.
I just found a shoe in my pebble.
There's a snake in my boot.
It was stabbed in my soul.
Well, considering you don't have a soul, I'm guessing you're meaning your shoe soul.
Yeah.
Someone's asking if you're getting bored of this route yet, Tom.
Yeah, a wee bit.
It's a nice route, but it's all kind of just trees.
It is a bit samey all the way.
Yeah. It's just sort of trees.
Oh, look, there's a river! Oh, look, there's some more trees. There's more trees.
Cry me a river. Mate, if we were driving a river...
Right. Oh, yeah, mate.
A river next to a river.
That's just not funny.
Cry me a river.
Good thing is, we're nearly at... I don't know how you pronounce it. Is it Crania Lark or Crania... Whatever you call it?
Crane's memes.
Chris, you... not Chris. Callum, you might be able to pronounce it.
He's Scottish.
Is it, Crania Lark? Something like that. Crying Larry or something like that. You'll see it in a minute anyway, we're near there.
It's
Yeah. Oh look, there's some actual moorland now.
I think it's Crinlach.
Crinlach! Yeah. That sounds like someone sneezing really badly.
Crinlach.
Frame rates, there we go.
According to Geordie Port, AWP is actually streaming the Aberdare. Is it actually?
Is you'd Aberdare?
I fucking would.
You'd Aber, I've got wood.
Yeah, I do.
But anyway. Yeah, it's Crinlach or whatever. Crinlach. I'm swear it's supposed to be Crinlarek or something like that.
Yeah. I think.
But this is where I'm going to have a potty break and go for a fag.
Okay.
How long have we got? We've got another 63 miles to go.
Oh, Jesus Christ. So we've only done like... Venta! Oh, Jesus Christ.
I might see if I can catch you in Buckleberry.
What, starting from Helensburgh?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck.
I'm pretty sure it's Helensburgh.
Wherever.
Like Edinburgh.
Who's Helen?
Who's Helen and what did you do to my mum?
That's my auntie. Yes, there you go, folks. You've learned something new about me. I have an aunt called Helen.
Well, as long as she's not called Karen.
Please tell me somebody finds that funny.
What?
You'll see. Ooh. When you see it.
Oh, why this, Tom?
Yeah. What I don't find funny is that we stopped in the wrong place, because look.
I tell you what, the VP skins for the DTG version of the Class 27.
Well, I just need to pull forward to the top of the Shush, Chris. Or I'll kill you.
Oh, okay.
I will kill you to death.
West Highland Line South. Let's go.
If I'd known you had this route, Chris, you bitch.
Yeah, I didn't think I did, but it was one of the first routes I actually got.
That's all I have to say.
I can definitely tell this is one of the first routes I got. Jesus Christ. I'm going to send a screenshot into admin chat.
No, you're not. So anyway, we're going to stop here and have a short break while I go for a cigarette. It'll only be about 3 minutes. I might get a bit more pork pie, actually.
Wee pork pie. I'm going to grab some tango. We'll be back in a minute. I got some tropical flavoured tango.
I got some tropical flavoured tropics.
I got a tropical flavoured jar of dirt.
What's inside it?
Mine.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be back shortly. So, in the meantime, I don't know. Chris, you can entertain the people. BRB.
Hi. Tom has a massive gap in his teeth. That's all I wanted to say. Wait for it. Now we're good. So, Antonio Banderas, how are you today?
Oh, no. Don't. Hi.
You fucking right. Anthony, relax. Thank God Callum's back. Callum.
Hello.
I can sniff your ass. Good call. Anyways, seeing as Tom isn't here to defend himself, let's just read out the script for episode 5, shall we?
While Tom isn't here to defend himself, everybody donate money to Patreon.
Fair enough. No, but hang on. Let me get the script for TDRS episode 5. Let's see where.
Chris!
What? Yeah, the scenarios, yeah.
That bottom one is my reaction upon seeing the third from bottom.
Yeah. Alright, episode 5, let's pull it up. The Great Custard Cream Robbery. No, I'm joking. Exactly, Kundrick. Good catch.
What the fuck?
Great was made. We know there's a commission from SSS to make one, but where it is at the moment, we don't know. No, the Great Custard Cream Robbery is an episode, Zapdor. That's episode 5 of season 8.
We've got to get out of here now. But why? What's the emergency? I might have ever so slightly stolen one of Mr. Chairman's dildo.
Zeke!
I fucking love that video just because of the randomness. Great. I really want Riley to re-upload that.
He didn't delete it. It's still there.
Yeah.
Zeke and Mr. B have just stolen one of my dildos and I need to get it back immediately.
Fucking hell, lads. This is
just lit as fuck. Yeah, fair enough, dude. All right, so we're at Saint.
Helensburgh. Yeah, Helensburgh. It's the bruh of Heather. Helen. Fuck!
Also, by the way, James Rice is a tart and he doesn't know how to make scenarios. Anyways.
Even though he did compliment me for streaming while I was making my freeway scenarios on the Cambridge lines. He was saying like, oh, thanks, Callum. Now I know how to make scenarios.
Real quick. No, you can't post links. I can, however. Let me go get it. I can do it because, you know, I'm, you know, moderator, but people who don't, you get basically insta-banned because we delete them.
What's your, what linky dink are you putting in?
I'm putting a link to your Pornhub site. Callum, it's the
great... Oh, shit, no one needs to see that.
It's the Great Custard Cream Robbery, you dingbat. Anyways, there we go. Oh, shit, Tom's in the chat. No one talk about episode 5. Or what we just spoiled, you guys, about the next episode.
I like episode 5 when the 9F comes in. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Mr. B. Nice day for a hijacking, eh? Punching! What's Alan's number? It's 08606, isn't it?
No, it's 4-1-1-1.
Fuck off. I know it's 08606.
Yeah, I did, Kundry. Did you mean the one Riley made? Because that's no longer on YouTube. That's the only episode 5 that exists because Riley took his... Well, he didn't take it down. He just made it private. Right.
Alan was built in 1959.
Ha, I'm older than Alan.
Yeah, I think as far as like character ages go, doesn't it? I think if I can round it off the top of my head, it goes something like this.
Uh-oh.
Vino, Theo, Otto, Colossus, Delatrip, Goose.
What's Goose's number? It's 5'4".
Oh, 5. Apparently he was built in 31. Hannah, Dave. Eddie. 257. Eustace, Buzz, Brian. Caracas, Mr. B, Ryan. Hello. Barry.
Barry?
Barry!
Barry!
I'm trying to remember who comes next. I think it's...
Huh. I've just found out about Goose. Goose was withdrawn in 1957.
Basically, there's somebody who keeps adding that stuff to the wiki on the character page. It's like, the engine that carried Goose's number was withdrawn and scrapped on this very date, because I went to VR database.
Congratulations.
Excuse me, I have a question. How do you get to VR database?
Shut the fuck up, Anthony.
Oh my god, stop.
Let's not make that a fucking meme.
It is already a meme now, Chris. There's nothing you can do.
Damn it. All right, Tom, how many coaches do I need to have on Buck?
1,000,000.
All right, doing 3 then.
How many?
23.
Oh.
They're on fire, James Edwards. Watch my latest RTR short.
Oh, hold on.
Alright, time to change after this cunt.
To be fair, I couldn't give a shit, because I'm going to take a screenshot in a sec. Hold on.
No.
There's not a railway line.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Oh man, there's another bridge. Right, looking at the line. Oh dear, can't go too fast. Problem is, speed limit all along it is like 40.
It's a bit of a slow burn, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, up to 100.
What?
I bet Chris is going to get to that 1 in 54 and be like, guys.
Guys, what? Anthony's just eaten the teacher.
Oh god, I remember what we were thinking of that.
Oh my god, can you remember that? Fucking, get off me, get off me! Oh, I hope this doesn't taste like chicken at all.
Don't, I still remember what happened when we were doing that. I hope this doesn't taste like chicken at all. And you two just burst out laughing for about a solid minute.
Yeah, because it was like, what was it? Someone asked the question, what would happen if Flying Scotsman and Barry, what would happen if Flying Scotsman and Barry were around children? You come up with, this doesn't taste like chicken.
It's fucked up in so many ways, but that's why it's so hilarious. And me and Callum's brains immediately go to the worst thing ever.
Barry eating children.
Chris, I'm afraid I have to say something really important now.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, why?
Fuck.
Shit.
Wank.
What are you
Shit, I said fuck. Oh fuck, I said shit.
Oh shit, I said fuck. Oh fuck, I said shit.
What are you drawing, Paddy? I'm drawing a chicken.
Barry comes in with a fucking axe.
Let me ask you a question then, Chris.
That's unacceptable, Tom.
Wow.
Yeah, I just countered your joke, bitch.
Yeah, no, I feel really depressed now. I'm gonna have to go fuck some sheep.
I just caught my fingers in a knot in my hair.
Oh, were you running your fingers through hair pretending someone was behind you doing it for you?
Shut up.
Someone said you should... Hang on. Someone just said you should spoil episode 10, season 9. It hasn't been written yet, dude.
Oh, yeah, everyone dies.
Even though I do know sort of what's going to happen in the final episode.
Yeah, basically Barry goes into the Marvel Universe, takes the Infinity Stones, and just turns everything into a pie.
Shit, Tom, you weren't supposed to tell them that. It was supposed to be a
surprise. Mr. Dark, I don't feel so good.
Zeke, I don't feel so good.
Oh,
Dave,
shit.
I feel like shit.
Hey, Tom.
What?
I'm doing about 63 miles an hour.
You're going to die. What's going to happen is you're going to fucking die, right? Everyone's going to die around you, and then everyone's going to masturbate on your face.
Oh, Bukake.
After we've died.
Yeah, we've died yellow.
I died at pink. Stripes.
I burn it down.
Really short and sovereign major.
I like having fluffy hair.
My god, you're such a puff, Callum. God's sake.
I'm sorry, Tom.
I know you can't help it. That's the funny thing.
What can you help?
Look, I like my hair. It's soft and it's floofy.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's just it, ladies and gentlemen. Can you guys believe that it's a whole year since we killed Mrs. Kindly?
Yeah.
Can you believe it's been a whole year since Christmas?
Can you believe it's been a whole year since Bag Puff Bag?
Christmas just wouldn't be Christmas without Christmas.
And Christmas. Anyway.
Huh.
I don't even know where I am anymore.
The tree seemed to have fucked off a little bit.
Suddenly.
Oh shit, no, don't, no, 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 no more trees.
I still find them quite intriguing.
Right, seriously, Chris, you need to fucking die.
You need to calm up.
Okay, sorry, I guess I'm barking up the wrong tree.
Oh, God!
Right, do you know what? These jokes are getting tremendously annoying.
Oh.
Hey, look, just because I'm such a sappy guy, you know, it's my bad.
Look, right, Chris, I think you should take a leaf out of Callum's book and stop this.
All right, fine, I'll leave you guys alone.
You know what? The root of this problem is clearly Anthony.
Look, guys, we're branching off topic here.
Damn it, you stole my joke.
Oh, damn it, you stole my lungs.
I'm kind of stumped at that fucking thing, Callum. You can't believe you stole my joke.
How?
What do you mean, how?
I'm very annoyed with all of you.
Yeah. I think your jokes are kind of acorny, though.
Oh, fucking hell.
Look, you need to shut your bush right now.
Okay, sure.
Please tell me at the end of the stupid tree puns.
Yeah. Though I do find them quite intriguing. No, I'm joking.
No, fuck off.
Chris, you son of a beach.
Hey, I see what you did there.
You need to stop pining on about this.
You're such a son of a bitch.
I actually said the son of a beech, but okay.
Yeah, he said birch. Birch and beech are two different types of trees.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And fucking spacker. What?
And Tom.
What?
Guess what?
What?
Your jokes are only okay?
No, but it's better if you say oak A.
That's what I said.
No, you said oak K.
No, I said oak A.
No, you said oak K.
What about oak B, for fuck's sake?
Or oak C, or oak D, or oak E.
Or OD.
Or overdose.
Yeah, that's what I said, OD. Oh, Callum. Guess what?
Light bulb.
Teapot.
Compared to us, you're just a sapling.
Bitch, I'm older than you!
Yeah, you wouldn't think that. Nah, Callum, you are far older than me, and you are quite the intelligent fella.
Oh.
Just a shame you can't show it in this chat.
But I'm still tremendously annoyed at all of you.
No, for fuck's sake. You need to grow up. That was a horrible tree pun.
Before. Yeah, that was actually not even a tree pun. You know what, Chris? There's an entire forest of jokes you could have used there.
Yeah. Don't worry, Tom. My jokes are usually quite hollow.
That would have been even funny if you said my oaks.
Yeah. My oaks are usually quite hollow. Also, Tom, are you stalling?
No.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
I slowed down for a station.
Ah, fair enough. That's some bullshit right there.
I thought you slowed down for the signal.
The signal was said, oh my god, we're about to crash.
The signal suddenly said, I'm a signal.
Someone just said, I want Tom to crash and hit a tree now.
No! Stop trying to ruin my life. I've ruined my life enough as it is.
Fuck off, you big brown cunt. You're ruining the story.
You're ruining the story, you big brown cunt. I love that meme.
And before anyone goes the racist route, it's a picture of a big dinosaur that's colored brown and God fucking being upset.
Yeah.
All right? You fucking poofs.
I'm pretty sure it was Jesus, wasn't it?
It's meant to be Jesus, I think.
Okay, well, Jesus Christ.
Like
Jesus H. Christ on a bicycle.
I like that picture of Jesus, of Raptor Jesus, throwing a disabled man down the stairs, and it just says, Raptor Jesus means well.
For fuck's sake.
Okay, I'm not sure how to take that one, but okay.
Oh my god, oh my god. I just remembered something.
Oh my god, we're about to crash.
No, we're not! I mean, yeah, we are.
Callum.
Mm.
looking memes.
Memes. Help, I accidentally built a shelf. Oh shit.
Okay, Callum.
Hmm.
I got another one for you.
Oh.
Guys, hate to be that guy, but there's no more forest! Hey!
Hey, Tom.
Hello.
Suddenly, out of nowhere.
Shut up! Don't make it happen.
We're getting really good at that noise.
So, what happened to the passengers that were on the last three coaches?
Oh, I've just crashed into them.
Oh, you weren't going to pick them up then?
I think they all just went, well, guess I die.
No. I basically buffered up to those coaches and I've chucked them off a hill and then I continued on my merry way.
Cool.
Like any proper Great Western engine would. Like any proper Great Western engine.
Chris, not funny. It's just not happening for you.
No.
Shut up! It's not funny. James hated to be reminded of his own order.
Goodbye, Percy! They went on a holiday, Edward Howard. That's a very big mouthful.
Funny enough, that's what I said to Dale last night.
Oh!
I still remember you came in and you said a certain sentence about getting something. And I was like, well, that's a way to introduce the stream. And you were like, wait, what? you know what I'm talking about, right, Callum?
I think I remember, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, guys, guess what? Last night I got my
I got my...
Yeah. And I was like, oh, that's one way to introduce the stream. And you were like, you were streaming?
Me?
You were so afraid.
I just had sex.
And it felt so lewd. I just thought about something. You know when Chris puts the...
Did it really hurt?
Yeah, it really hurt, yeah, because your voice was in there.
Oh.
Anyways, yeah, so when Chris puts the Abadare on his online shop, we're finally going to get away... We're finally going to get a Great Western pack. Or page.
And then we're going to get Chris to fill it up with loads of awesome Great Western engines, like...
The Great Bear and Dean Single.
What about
and,
what happens if you combine the Great Bear with an Abadare? Do you get the Great Abadare?
No, you get a Great Single.
So you don't get hot singles in your area?
No, you get the hottest album of 1973.
Oh, what? Smash Dreams?
Yeah, wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Oh my god, do you remember that?
I remember we were all dying, because it's just, you post a screenshot, and I'm just like, oh, it looks like they're about to drop the hottest album of 1973.
One of the blurbs should have said, I don't even know who these people are. Oh, oh my god, look, it's a lovely viaduct! Woohoo!
I've been driving for a while now, and I haven't checked my engine for like a few minutes. Oh, I'm overfilling the boiler.
Oh, I'm off.
Oh, you are?
No, you.
Oh, okay. No. I'm good. I'm about to hit a big downhill. I can see Glenn Douglas North Track.
Can you see Glenn?
No, because I'm legally blind.
Can you see Douglas?
Yeah, he's currently fucking Donald. Incest for life.
Cheeky.
Wait, what?
That's an interesting question, actually. I know people have said to me before about it, but what do you guys think of this? Because I've got the answer for it, which is, with the whole thing with Leander and Dave, if they ever, you know, would that be incest or not? Because some people would class them as cousins.
I mean, incest is wincest, isn't it?
I would actually argue it's probably where they're built.
Thank you, Callum. That's pretty much what I was going to suggest.
Oh shit, I'm gonna derail.
Good. You deserve it.
There's no way I'm getting past this curve without derailing.
But anyway, like... yeah. Avoiding Chris's derailment because we're not talking about that at the moment.
Can't.
Dave went built at Vulcan Foundry and Leander went built at Crew.
Yeah. No, Tom, she was built at Shaft.
She built in your ass.
That explains why she wouldn't die.
See, this section line is nicer now because it's all open. We're on embankments and bridges and things. I mean, you can actually have a look around the train.
It does look like a massive cum stain on one of the hills.
But... I mean, yeah, I mean that was me when I found out that, well, I can't tell you, but...
Exactly, same here.
Hold on, is that a tablet catcher on the side of the cab?
Yeah.
Woo!
It's to catch its pills as it's going along. Because it needs medication.
LSD!
How far are we going? Oh, shit. What's the curvature like for a minute? Oh, the curvature's like nothing for a bit. We just coast at 60.
How far have we got left now? I'm guessing...
We've got 52 and a half miles. I love watching Wolf Charles Valkyr go round and round.
Yeah.
Why?
That's why.
Oh.
Oh, it's a very good reason.
Can I have some?
No.
Oh, okay. You know why I want some?
Because you're a homosexual cheeseburger?
No, because you'd Abadare.
I would then.
You'd Abadare.
To be fair, it looks like I'll be doing my dark tries on Sunday of that, so.
Nice.
Possibly. But it depends on how many people get murdered between now and then. Would you like to? Hello.
Tom, if I kill 42 people, does that help?
Yes.
Good.
If Anthony kills one person though, that helps even more, because one Anthony kills like I don't even know. They sort of count for like 100.
Wait, one Anthony kill counts as 100 people. If I kill 42 people, it counts as
negative 15.
Well, oh fuck. How does me killing people create 15 people?
Simple.
Just does.
Reproduction.
Chris, right, I'm not sure if you're aware of it.
Oh no, I don't mean you're reproducing, I mean go to China.
Which, and currently everyone is dying from flu over there, so thank for that.
So, still go to China, because then we have one less problem.
Oh, wow! Wow!
You're telling me to go to China so I can die of Chinese plague?
No, you can cure it. Just be really happy.
Chris, what the fuck are you on about? I normally ask you what the fuck you're on about, but what the fuck are you on about?
Right, Chris, are you suggesting that if I go over there, shag a guy's sees, the Chinese plague will no longer be a thing?
Yes!
Where does your brain work? How do we cure disease? Simple. We'll get one man to fuck all the infected people and then they'll be fine. I wonder what happens in that head of yours, Chris.
Probably this sound. Me love you long time.
Me love you long time.
Oh, Calmo.
There goes our Chinese audience. But that said, I think the plague's taken them all anyway.
Oh my god, Callum! Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to apologise for this absolutely atrocious behaviour on our part.
Right, that's it. We're nuking Twelford.
What?
I'm eating.
That was even more racist, Chris.
I wasn't putting on an accent.
Bullshit.
Okay, kind of was.
You said, we're nuking at Telford. What the fuck?
First, we sneak in covertly. We steal all cats so we have food. Then we nuke Telford.
Are they Russian or Chinese?
What is going on?
Chris, they're not one and the same. You see, my friend, in Mother Russia.
Look, the only comparison between China and Russia is the fact that they're both communist countries.
Well, there's another difference.
Huh? Mm-hmm.
Sorry, there's another similarity.
What?
They're both countries.
Are they?
Actually, I can't deny you that. Yeah, China and Russia are both countries.
Yeah, but so is England, and so is Norway.
Yeah, yeah. We don't talk about that, but like, there's also another thing they have in common.
What?
Murder?
They're both on Earth.
Are they?
Yeah.
Wow.
Actually, there's another thing. They can all see the same sun.
That's a myth.
We all breathe the same air.
Oh, I'll tell you what, right? You know people who are lactose intolerant?
Yeah.
Right, they must start, like, literally falling over and crying and everything when they find out they actually live in the Milky Way.
That, tell all the vegans that.
Oh, that's amazing, yeah. Oh, that'd be even funnier.
Could you imagine if we named the solar system the Beef Galaxy? That would, the vegetarians, the vegans, the Indians would go mad.
No, I'm pretty sure the Indians would be fine because they would care.
Oh yeah, they worship. But,
yeah, they'd be happy. They'd be over the moon.
Quite literally.
Like the cow that jumped over the moon.
I love how we've got all this banter going on and yet only 15 fuckers are watching this.
13 now because you spoke about it.
Fuck!
That's because people don't know what they're missing.
No, people are watching Aberdares at the moment, I know that.
Yeah, fair
because,
enough.
Because, ladies and gents, you'd Aberdare!
I would.
Oh, I'm eating pork pie. It's one of the only things I've been able to eat with my mouth to wet in. Because of my impacting wisdom teeth. Which I'm surprised at because I don't have any wisdom.
I don't know, I'm eating something else right now.
Is it cock?
No, it's plastic.
Alright. I mean, you do you, man.
Lol, the other viewers are Tom's other accounts.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, but 50 of them got banned.
From the server?
By me.
Chris, why'd you do such a thing?
I'm looking at Reese's stream. He's driving the wrong type of Aberdare. He's driving it with red frame.
Oh, grow up, Callum.
I didn't know there was a wrong type of train that you could drive.
The Aberdare looks better with black frames. Lime green, black frames.
You know, that could be counted as racism right there, Callum.
Yeah.
Well, I don't like red. I prefer black.
Are you being racist towards red-framed locomotives?
Might be.
Wow.
Now, don't get me wrong, right, it depends, right, because if you look at Vela's
rival... That hole that you're digging, it's getting deeper, mate.
No.
Yeah, like, man, you're almost in China, better watch out for that plague.
For fuck's sake!
No, but what I'm saying is, like, some red frame locos look nice. Like, if you look at the Vela's rival locos that were painted yellow with the red frames, that looks quite nice.
Does it?
Mm-hmm.
Does it? Why don't I believe you, Callum?
It is nice. I just don't think red and green go well together.
They do for Santa Claus.
Well.
Also, I happen to know that Gwion is watching Reese's stream.
Is that because Gwion's a little bitch?
Anyways, can I just point something out?
That we're driving a blue train?
That too. But do you know why Mrs. Claus is always so angry?
Why?
Because Santa only comes once a year.
Did you know that she's also filing for divorce? Because it turns out he's actually a massive paedophile.
Yeah.
I got nothing else. That's all I got.
Alright, well, Tom, how far are you from your destination now?
46 miles.
Alright, cool. I thought I'd just let you know that I'd never put a destination, so I have no clue where the fuck I am.
Excellent.
Because you're a moron.
I'm in a 40 limit, if that helps.
You're a 40 limit. I'm in a danger zone. Oh, shit.
Oh, that reminds me. I kind of fucked up when I made my Spotify playlist.
Cool.
Because one of the first songs I put in was Africa by Toto.
Mm.
And then the next one was Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins.
Okay, I have no concept of what this means.
Are you implying that Africa is a danger zone?
No. I said Africa, not China.
You just... Oh my god, Chris. Are you actually special? Wait, don't answer that because we already know the answer.
I think we all know that Chris is very special.
I didn't notice something, actually. I don't know if anyone else on stream noticed so far. The light blue on the Caledonian light blue is slightly different between the Cardian tender and the 191.
You couldn't tell that.
Yes.
The Cardian one is slightly darker.
That's all I have to say on that one.
So is the red, actually. The red is darker on the Cardian tender.
Hmm.
So is the R, actually.
So is the C.
And so is the logo. And so is the sky. And the tree. Oh, back to trees, Tom.
Shit.
Oh, is this where I think it is?
Where?
I think I'm approaching where you took your fag break.
Well, Krendlark, whatever it's called.
Oh, no, never mind. That's still a ways away.
I just got my favourite whistle.
Didn't it?
No.
Don't
again. Boop, 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 boop. That's an accurate representation of what that whistle sounds like, by the way.
Yeah, my favourite is noot noot, followed by the beep 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 beep. I can't remember if the Cardine had a noot noot.
No, it had a poot poot instead.
Oh shit, we're going uphill.
Uh-oh.
Oh shit.
I said fuck.
Oh fuck.
I said shit.
Oh shit.
I said shit. Oh shit!
Fuck!
Here at DDJP, we value our swearing.
Cunts.
What a bunch of fucking cunts. Anyway.
Fucking cunts. I can't stop brushing my hair.
I can't stop brushing my teeth.
Tom, you'll have no teeth left.
I'm just randomly blowing the bee whistle now to find a good whistle.
The only good whistle is the noot noot.
I just got noot noot.
Yay!
How far have we got left now?
You're asking me this every 5 minutes, dude. We've got 43 miles.
I just want to keep updated.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
You're fibbing.
I'm not fibbing.
You are fibbing.
I can't lie.
Callum, are you sexy?
I know what you're going to do, you arsehole.
You can't win either way, I don't think, mate.
You can't win, Callum. If you say a word, I shall become more savage than you can possibly imagine.
What, even more than you already are? Wow, I didn't think that was possible.
If you want my body and you think I'm sexy, Callum Sugar, let me know.
Oh my god, please shush.
If you really need, just reach out and touch me. Apparently Rod Stewart's got a model railway now.
Oh my god, really?
Yeah, I heard it on the radio a couple of months back. There was an article on it in Railway Modelling. And the radio presenter then decided to take the piss.
Sounds fair.
Well, hey, that's BBC Radio Shropshire for you.
That's right, I'm one of those sad fucks that listens to Radio 4.
I'm one of those sad fucks who listens to myself.
I think Radio 4 is quite interesting if you want to listen to particular topics and then just think about it. I like listening to... I quite like BBC Radio Shropshire for... There's a particular time when the presenter is always sort of talking to a guy who's outside the studio and keeps slagging him off. It's almost like he's talking about an imaginary friend. I just like the idea of radio presenters that have ever slipped their minds. I also listen to Greatest Hits a lot. I'll listen to that when I'm in a van. And the thing is that I'm always happy to listen to them until they start playing Queen. I like listening to Queen, don't get me wrong, but I don't like hearing it every other song. And they only ever play two Pet Shop Boys songs. I've only heard them play West End Girls and What Have I Done to Deserve This, which are great songs, I love them, but whenever I hear Pet Shop Boys song on the radio, I'm just like, oh, I want to listen to It's a Sin or I'm a Stupid or something like that.
So Tom, how are you doing tonight? Are you stalling?
No, I slowed down for the junction again because I thought I'm going to be switching to the other side.
Yeah.
Going to the dark side. I think I might need to give my hair a little bit of a trim. Where's my scissors? I tell you what, Tom, something we're going to have to experiment now. Now that I've new fancy graphics, right? We're going to have to see about doing a multi at some point.
I'm still waiting for a fucking War Department base. Mm-hmm. Anthony.
Anthony.
That was a hint for you to speak, cuntface.
He's dead.
Be off down with two tanks and keep him with Fanny Bed.
They're dead.
Yeah, he's definitely dead.
Yeah.
So, what are we doing?
Masturbating furiously.
No, I thought you were driving the train.
No.
Well, how else is he going to make pressure?
Well, I need to be under pressure. Yep, Chris, me and him are in sync again.
Look, he needs heat to make steam, right? Where'd you get heat from? Friction.
Not you. Oh, hi.
Alright, Gene, calm down.
Zapdoor, actually, we know. Because they announced it a while back. Someone said, he said, what if I... what if I tell you Victor Works is making the 210 austerity?
Well, it's kind of logical they're going to do that because...
It's the logical next step from the 280. Yeah.
Not just that, but they have said it, announced it on the blog.
They've also said hi to Chris, that guy.
It's also kind of what they do, like they did with the heavy freight tanks.
I'm just going to put banana in chat so people can click on my channel and subscribe. Hashtag sellout. No, I'm joking.
I'm doing like 70 at the moment.
Ooh. If you keep this up, Tom, we won't be done in half an hour.
I doubt it, because I'm going to have to slow down again in a minute for speed limits by the looks of it.
I'm pretty sure the speed limit is 70.
Shush. I'm more looking at that corner that's coming up and the rest of the corners that are coming up soon.
And that one, and that one, and shit.
Oh, I didn't slip that side of that. Yes, I am cutting my hair. I've got quite good at it, as it Ow. When I look at the skizzers, there they are.
Ah, sat on my hairbrush.
Right. Coming up to the fag break place. Possibility of catching Tom? 0%.
not how you do possibility.
Exactly.
Prettier and prettier and prettier.
Ow! Yeah. Well, I've got nice hair again. It's gotten some bounce.
Bounce, 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 bounce.
Little own brand shampoo because you're worthless. Other supermarket chains are available.
Thomas, do you think your name in the Gobbler Affair?
No.
Yes, sir.
I just noticed we all went silent.
While I was chopping my hair out.
And also, I've got toothache, so. Oh, this bit looks nice, doesn't it? Look, guys.
Yeah, this looks nice. Now there aren't any fucking trees in the way.
Exactly, fucking trees.
Fucking trees. Who do they think they are?
Trees?
Yeah. Bastard fucking trees. That's quite. There are some nice bridges on this route.
It's just a shame that you got a load of boring bits before you get to the good bits.
Yeah. Like right now. Where I actually genuinely fell asleep. Not because I'm watching the stream or anything. No, I'd probably stay awake by at that point.
I was thinking, Tom, that bridge that you've just got over.
Mm-hmm.
Was it a bridge?
Surprisingly enough, Chris, yes, it was.
Yeah.
Would the... I can't remember if you said that you're wanting to... was it rebuild the bridge to Soma in the series, but if you did, would it be that type of bridge?
I don't know yet.
Might be cheaper to build if it was that type of bridge.
Would it though?
Might be. It's an OPTD.
Open text titty dick.
Shut the fuck up, Chris.
I become the new Nick. Yeah!
I like seeing the Valve gear go around on that.
Yeah, I know. It's addictive, isn't it?
Ooh, I can kind of tell. Yeah, I can definitely tell what you mean. That's actually really addictive.
Mesmerizing.
Just like hardcore drugs.
Heroin.
Chris, stop being on the same wavelength with me. It's annoying.
It's just because we're so similar, but so different.
I find it funny how, like, classes like the... The 812 and the jumbos and stuff, they outlive these. I just find that remarkable.
It would be the amount of hammer blow these things had.
Yeah.
I still don't know what that is.
Hammer blow is the force of the pistons acting on the wheels, which equates to how heavy it... That's why wheels have got back counterbalances. It's because the force is going down onto the track through the wheels.
Okay.
And these had the heaviest hammer blow of any LMS engine. Which is really weird, seeing as they look quite small.
Oh, I just derailed.
Well done, Chris.
Well done.
Points were set against me.
Were they?
Yeah.
That's why you set your final destination, Chris.
I had the feeling it was going to happen. Whatever. Buckleberry did his job, he derailed. Anyways, before we forget... That's the noise of my brain cells.
What brain cells?
Exactly.
I'm also pretty sure that if we're talking about hammer... Because the counties had quite a heavy hammer blow, didn't they?
Yeah, that due to their boiler pressure as well.
Yeah, that's why they were relegated to working between it was Birmingham and Birmingham to Shrewsbury. That's where they were relegated to for the most part. That was the only place in the country where they can actually utilise their proper performance. Also, if there's someone out there who wants to do a steam era route, or at least between Birmingham and I know there's a freeware route for the Wenlock branch, which I've got, but there's no scenery on it at all. It's actually kind of poo.
32 miles to go.
Oh, I'll tell you what I saw while I was on my... I went through Ironbridge and I saw an old railway viaduct on the other side of the river, so I think at some point...
No, you didn't. That.
Yes, I did.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, I did. So I'm thinking, like, probably on Sunday I might just go and have a little look at it. Oh, it's amazing to think that such an impressive looking loco was had its career cut so short. It's quite a modern looking machine too.
It is. That's the sad thing.
Yeah. And the Cardine tender really suits it.
Mm.
Look at the chop chop. It's amazing the thing that what we're looking at now, once upon a time, a very common sight in Scotland.
Oh, nothing.
Rocks.
No, seeing what's it? These blue engines charging, charging everywhere in Scotland.
They didn't charge everywhere in Scotland, though.
In most parts of Scotland, then.
In a very small amount of Scotland.
Well, it was a Caledonian's territory anyway. That was on the. It was on the. It was on the west of Scotland, wasn't it?
Pretty much. I'm not going to pretend I know everything about the Caledonian Railway unless I ask Chris Wilson.
The only thing I know is Eo Scotland.
Anthony, what is your problem with Scotland?
Yeah, I've got a pretty big hate boner for Scotland for some reason.
Mm. It's because his name is Anthony.
No, you're joking. It's not.
Yeah. It's Jim.
Yeah. I quite like a lot of Scottish engines. I'd certainly like to see some North British stuff. That's for sure.
I also in North British Atlantic, you know, the H10.
H10, I'm going to Google that. No, wouldn't that be the C10 if it was an Atlantic?
Oh yeah, it would have been C10, yeah. Doo-doo-doo.
The only thing I could see is not a, well, I can see an Atlantic tender engine, British, under the classification C10.
Yeah, that's the one I'm on about.
Yeah. Oh, that's a beefy looking thing. And I kind of like as well how the cab has got a little bit of Raven as well. That's cool. I personally like to see the Glens. Those are handsome engines. I also quite like the livery too. Is someone clipping their toenails?
No.
I can hear like a bit of a snapping sound, like someone's clipping their toenail or something.
Where the fuck's that coming from,
though? Oh, is it you with your flick knife?
Oh, no, you mean this?
Yeah.
No, that's me just cutting shit. I'm bored.
Aren't we all?
I'm not bored. I'm quite happy.
Well, look at Callum being happy.
Yeah.
Would you like a cookie?
Yeah, we'd love a cookie.
Hold on, you're gonna have to walk down to the store and buy one.
Keep cookie.
Okay. Hashtag control alt delete.
What? Ooh.
the J83 in North delivery looks
Well, that's slightly homosexual.
Really, Chris? Coming from me, yeah?
Shit. That's slightly heterosexual.
Arsehole. Arseholes. Ooh. Someone's even made a model of a peppercorn A1 in a British Railways sort of pseudo North British livery. Surprisingly enough, the logo that they've done it on is called North British. It looks quite smart, actually.
Ooh, and you gauge the issue.
Yeah, looking back on the tens.
Lord. Speaking of Anthony, he's finally back.
By the way, I don't know why. I basically have this bug where I get really into just making lists of things. Did you lot see basically that list I ended up sticking up in train chat the other day?
I think I remember that.
Yes. Because basically, I just had this urge to figure out when exactly was the last times that everything in the National Collection actually ran in press.
Yeah.
And it makes you realize very few members of the National Collection have actually run in 2010.
Yeah. Of course, they don't have the habit of, restoring engines to working condition either. So,
by the way, if you were wondering, though, on that list, why everything was in green, there were certain engines in green. Those are basically engines that were listed on the NRM sort of approved document. You know, the one they published last year saying, okay, these are the engines that we're going to let be steamed, possibly, for the next 15 years.
Yeah.
So basically, if you wanted the Super D or City of Truro running again, sorry, shower luck.
don't worry. We can always go back in time and watch them when they were in their prime.
Time.
Waits for no one.
I'll wait for someone to say of your life, but never mind.
Of your life. Haha.
You suck eggs.
There's your list. Mind you, I've seen a large chunk of the engines that last run were in the 80s. That was that's when they just used to steam basically everything.
That's because it was acceptable in the 80s.
Yeah. It's acceptable in
just the 80s. Just the way of seeing, like, on this list, last steamed in the 1980s, the Stirling single.
I'm Jim fucking Stirling, son.
Mind you, it did actually come as a bit of a surprise to me, though. But, like, when I actually found out, engines like the NRM Stanutang and Fundesley, they have actually steamed in Prez. It was just whilst they were cooped up at Brestingham, so no one actually paid attention to To be honest, Fundesley is one of those cases where you actually kind of feel really bad for it. Because it's in a bit of a unique position. It's the only surviving engine built for the company that it served. And granted, there's surviving engines that ran on that network, on that route, but not the actual company. And yet, it's one of those engines the NRM have just basically completely forgotten about. Like, could you imagine if someone turned around and said, hey, is anything happened with Fundesley? And they just went, oh, what's Fundesley? Oh, we owned that?
Better sell it.
All right, Bressingham, you can have your Fondersley. Hooray! Said Bressingham.
I'm gonna stick two things in memes because Callum needs to laugh and so does Anthony.
Memes?
Out my ass!
Oofed.
And then there's this one. Alright, so since
my tummy's wrong.
We'll go eat. So since it's been more than 5 minutes, tell them how far you got left.
20 miles.
Wow, you're not too far then.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's very far.
I know.
Is this one of those routes where it doesn't feel like it's that long, but because it's a line that basically is really twisty and turny, you can't really go very fast?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. But that said, it is a 100-mile route, but it's mostly single track. I just find that remarkable.
So,
for Lino,
where you'll be, I'll go.
See, Tommy, pay attention to your music.
Even though it's a Roy Kasop song.
You know where they're from and what that means?
A Roy Kasop?
Yeah.
Suddenly, Anthony had a bit
of a deal. They're Norwegian?
They're Norwegian, and it means, well, you could basically call it smoke shroom.
Oh, magic mushroom.
Yeah. Anyways, you had a thought, Anthony?
Basically, like, you know the, song called, you know where you'll be, I'll go.
No, yeah. Stop following me.
Where you'll be, I'll know.
Go away. Leave me alone. I want my privacy in my old age.
Where you'll be, I'll find you.
Police! Police!
Lino jumped about. I mean, to be fair, Lino is quite the jumper for his age, wouldn't you say?
Lino was jumping about 10 miles north today.
Whee!
Tom, was that a red signal you passed?
No.
Is your name Tom?
I think the funniest, you know, Lino jumped about 5 miles north and he just falls on his side.
You still need to do a video on the top 10 TDRS gags, Tom. Like the top 10 funniest moments. Am I right in saying that the most modern thing to go up the West Highland line is just sprinters? Is that the newest thing that's gone up there?
No.
What is the newest thing to go up there then, Chris?
Probably Person.
Hold on, it's Clarence. Random Clarence sat on the platform, being a train. My I'm blue, if I was green, I would die. 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 Oh, Jesus. I think we should talk about shit.
Okay.
I have two shits today.
Oh my god, Callum!
You did give me approval to start talking shit. Yeah, everybody heard, right? Chris definitely approved of me to start talking shit.
Right, so... Fuck. Well, I guess the only thing to ask now is, Mr. Dog, what's your favorite cowie woke emoji? I think Tom's muted.
Is he muted?
Or he's like, he's dead. He's dead, Jim, but not as we know it.
Tom. His tooth is either, like, really sore, he's fallen asleep.
No, he's not asleep. I can hear him move. What's my favorite running joke that's made in the server? Well, Callum's voice acting career is pretty funny.
What?
I'm joking. Probably the one thing that always gets me to laugh is the whole, good evening.
Good evening.
Ah.
This might work out right. Oh, who knew this? I think one of my favourite running jokes in the server is the... What's it? Kicking James Wright out of call.
Yeah, it's funny because every... Hey, screw you, Railway Productions, you fucking cunt. Anyways, oops. There he goes. No, I think... Saying that, my favorite joke is when Callum tries to kick someone out the call and then end up kicking them from the server.
That only happened once. I've been a good boy since then. I should like to explain to everybody that we don't take pleasure in that. Well, we don't misuse our admin or moderator powers.
Much.
No, not much at all. It's only against James Ryan.
Yeah, and that's not abuse. That's just justice.
It's because he's
How do you say it? A cunt?
Well, he's a kinky fucker. He enjoys it. Pain.
Alright, I'm gonna... This is so much better. Oh. I just put a pillow in my chair because my ass hurts. I think you've been up there too roughly, Callum.
I'm sorry about that. No. I did warn you that my first boyfriend couldn't sit down for 2 weeks.
No. You didn't penetrate me. Remember, you were 10 minutes in about to finish, and I asked, are you in yet? That's got to be, like, the ultimate fucking insult. Like, you've been taking it for 10 minutes, and it's just like, you in yet? Callum went quiet. I think I just hit a bit too close to home.
You're a big meanie bum bum. Big meanie weenie bum bum.
I do have a big weenie.
No, you don't, Chris.
You wish. Anyway, so yeah.
Look, we all know, right? But when you do your thing on slapping your balls on the table, the real thing is, right? This is actually how it sounds.
What if my dick? If my balls are heavy enough to make my table turn into glass, then yes. Anyways, before we break something.
Ooh.
Ow, my ear. Ow, my ear. Ow, my ear. Callum, please.
That's my whiskey crystal, that is. Yeah, I've got a crystal tumbler. I need some whiskey, though. I haven't had whiskey at all this year yet. I'm starting to feel good.
Real quick, everyone quiet. Tom, can you make a noise? Dark DJ.
Is he falling asleep?
That'd be funny as fuck.
Well, we'll see what happens. If he crashes at the end of the stream, then we'll know he's fallen asleep.
Ah, then again, Callum, that's a bit of an issue, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because, who's going to stop the stream?
Oh. We'll have to carry it on until Tom wakes up.
That or he is trolling us.
He might have gone for a fag break. He just left his engine running.
Well, just watch the controls in the top left. Like, if they change, we know he's awake.
Now, at the moment, I've got it on, like, low resolution because my internet is poo.
Zero reg, 25 reverser, train brake, 31 running.
Been zero reg for a while, though, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
What's his water level at?
72, 71.
Yeah. Actually, I don't know what the water consumption is like on the inside.
Me neither. Anthony, are you alive?
No.
Okay, good. Help?
What's happened?
We have a sneaking suspicion that Tom may have fallen asleep. No, hang on. if we're gonna do that, ladies and gentlemen, you have approximately 15 seconds to mute the stream for about 10 seconds, because Anthony's about to get fucking loud.
Okay, I'm just gonna give you a warning. I'm gonna give you a countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Wake up!
Well, that didn't work.
Oh, well, I tried.
Yeah.
Well, to be fair, Anthony.
I can do.
To be fair, Anthony, that was rather weak. Let me try.
Oh, oh my god, the house is on fire! The children are burning! Ah!
Callum, please.
Did that help?
Alright.
I think Tom's comatose.
Nah, he's not comatose.
Alright.
Right. Well, in that case,
where's the end of the route?
Fort William.
I can't tell where he is. That's the thing. We don't know how many miles there is.
Well, I can definitely tell that his regulator isn't moving and he's slowing down quite drastically.
Hmm.
If he stalls, we know what's happened.
Well, he's been coasting for a while. Oh. I think he's fallen asleep.
I'm pretty sure of that too. In worst case scenario, I'll just call him on Facebook and see if he wakes up to that. Right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've had fun listening to us crazy people ramble.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think we might be going to die soon.
Well, either the boiler's going to blow up or he's going to stall, one of the two.
Yeah, he's left the fireman on, so I think his firebox is pretty much filled up above the brim now.
Oh, look at the fire mass. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Has this ever happened before?
I don't know. I don't think Tom's ever fallen asleep on stream before. Has anybody got Tracy's number or something? So we can say, Trace, Tom's fallen asleep.
But worst case scenario, literally just call him on Facebook, he'll wake up. Like, if he actually just, you know, crashed at the end, that's probably what we gotta do.
Yeah. It's just coasting down the line.
Yep. And this is what happens when Callum takes over the conversation, people. People fall asleep.
Oh, thanks! You're a massive dick.
I am what I have.
No, Chris, no.
Oh, he's speeding up, lads.
He still hasn't opened the reg, so I think he's just going down another hill.
Exactly. Good evening. I'm going to try something.
Oh.
Oh, did he just disappear and come back?
I did that.
Oh.
Yeah.
what are we gonna do?
Well, since this live stream is probably gonna be taken down now, ladies and gentlemen, go over to Epic Bastard. Check out Rails of Refuge. Should probably be out.
Once you know what? I tell you what, it's a shame that he hasn't got TeamViewer running, because then you could go in there, Chris, and make sure that he doesn't fucking crash.
I can make sure it doesn't crash and I can turn off the fucking stream. We don't know, Rail Productions. Because, you know, we can't do anything.
No. He's left the engine coasting and it's still coasting, but he was putting coal on the fire. It's still putting coal on the fire. I think pounds now. But hold on. No, hold on. 1400 pounds at least.
Yeah, 1,430 pounds.
Yeah, so. Yeah! I think he's pretty much put his fire out by now.
Huh. Well,
he's managed to coast a long way.
And I will just say, okay, he's managed to hold 15 viewers while asleep. Fucking legend.
Oh god, look at his steam generation rate. It's gone below 1,000, I think, isn't it?
Yep.
Oh, oh, by the way, Callum. Mm-hmm.
You have a slight echo.
Oh. Shit's on.
Don't matter. Shit's gonna be taken up.
Let me move my microphone away from my desktop speakers. There. There we go. I've put my microphone beside the chair.
Yeah, good.
Mm-hmm.
I have to disagree there, Tonks, because technically I get more views than Tom when he's asleep and when I'm awake. And to be fair, even if I didn't, he's got 3,500 something subscribers. I got 185. I'm winning here.
Oh god, he's speeding up again.
Yep.
Right, so what's going to happen first, right? Is Tom going to wake up? Is the game going to crash? Or is the engine going to crash?
I'd say engine.
I don't know, because we must be less than 20 miles now.
Yeah, no, far less than 20 miles, mate.
God, this is speedy. Right, we've got to run away.
Oh shit, yeah, we do.
I'm
gonna move him again, see if that works. No.
Try phoning him on Facebook.
What'd you say?
Try calling him on Facebook. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a slight tech glitch.
Well, should I actually try to call him?
Yeah.
All right. Alright, we'll see how this goes. No. Messenger of fear and sight, dark deception kills the light. Please tell me you got that, Callum. It's a song, yeah. Messenger of fear and sight, dark deception kills the light. Rabbit children watch the sea, pray for father roaming free. The thing that should not be Metallica. All right, phoning Tom on Facebook in 3, 2, 7. Was that you, Callum?
Huh?
Did you move?
Yeah, that was me.
Okay. Yeah, no answer.
Uh-oh. Yeah, he's fallen asleep.
Yeah, no, there's like a 20% chance he has. Worst case, we're gonna have to message Tracy.
Message Tracy. Tell Tracy to wake Tom up.
Or we could just, you know, get Anthony to call him.
Does Anthony have his phone number?
Yes.
Anthony.
Don't you remember they hooked up back in 2014?
What? Anthony. We need
I just said.
Phone Tom.
Worst case scenario, phone Tom.
I think this is worst case scenario, to be honest.
No, he hasn't crashed yet.
Wait, so we're going to wait until after he crashes to try and wake him up?
No. Yes.
Dom! Dom, we're going out of control down the hill!
Oh shit, I think we're getting close.
What, the end of the line?
I'm pretty sure.
Oh, God.
Oh, hello, Tom.
Hello.
Did you fall asleep?
Maybe.
We tried getting into contact with you, mate.
Yeah, I just saw that I've missed a call on Facebook.
Yeah, all good, mate, all good. Yeah, I think you made it just in time, because I think you're coming into the end. And you've got 1,443 pounds in the firebox right now. Nice.
It's alright, it's because of my toothache. I think I just sort of dozed off a little bit.
It's all good. Not your fault.
Well, I'm sorry. Hang on, have I coasted it all the way from... How long have I been coasting for?
For ages. It's been bloody hilarious, because we've been like, Tom. Tom, hello, Tom.
Well, it was. I got up to get some painkillers, and then I just sat down on the sofa, and then I've just heard my phone go off. I've looked at it, and I've realised what's happened. But fucking good timing on my part. Look, we're at Fort William.
The whole plan was, Tom. I'll say to Anthony, look, if he crashes at the end, then we call. If not, we wait until he crashes, then we call. But hey, you saved it.
Surprisingly enough. That's the first time I think that's ever happened.
Yeah, that's what we were talking about. That.
Yeah, I'm just thinking, that's such a Thomas the Tank ending. It's like, the driver woke up just in time.
Please keep the stream up, it's hilarious.
I think I might have to, because I'm going to have to watch back and see what you lot said.
We didn't say anything bad, I just put one promotion and then we were just kind of worried about you.
Right, Tom, we're speeding up down the hill.
Oh yeah, and Anthony and Callum shouted down the mic because we thought you'd fallen asleep at the computer.
Well, I mean, the good news is both my passengers, half my passengers got to Fort William.
The rest were killed by Buckleberry Crane.
Yeah, oh my god. Wait, hang on. I looked at the map here last. I've coasted all the way up there and along there all the way to Fort William while asleep.
What?
What the fuck?
Jesus.
Well, Tom, what did we learn today? Sleeping helps you win.
Well, sleeping certainly did something. Well, I suppose that's the end of the stream then. I think I might have to think about going to bed or something.
That'd be a good idea.
But first, I think as I've now woken up, I suppose I better reverse my coach into a carriage siding or something.
Yeah.
Can't even do that.
Yeah. I should be able to. Hold on.
Yeah, okay, you're good.
I think you have ever so slightly murdered your player. Oh.
That's all right.
Yeah, you need to also, you know, inject. I would just say though, kudos to you, Tom. You're the only person I know that would manage to keep 15 people watching while you're asleep.
Wow.
Bloody hell, man. Jesus. I know I've fallen asleep a few times. I think I've fallen asleep during while we were streaming. Yeah. I think only once. Have I fallen asleep while cut just before the end of... I don't know, tell a lie. I did that once when I was doing a... And I woke up to see my train crashing in Manchester.
You wake up, see the buffers.
Oh, God.
Man, that was weird. Because, you see, Tom, the thing that got to us the most was like, well, if Tom doesn't stop in time, or if Tom, like, you know, doesn't wake up, How are we going to end the stream?
Oh, yeah.
we'll just be sat here, like, right, I gotta go to work. I gotta head off to work. I don't want to be sat here just trying to entertain all the peeps and all that.
No, we wouldn't entertain the people. We would have fucking been like, yeah, guys, Tom's asleep. Good luck.
We've gone sleepy boo boo.
Well, that's one way of ending the stream, I suppose. Yeah. I don't know how that happened.
Well, at least... Oh!
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what just happened there, but that's one way of finishing.
What the fuck?
I think the point switched on you as you were going across them.
Oh, God.
Well, hey, I got my crash!
Yeah, you got your crash, ladies and gents.
You tried to do multi-track drifting instead.
Okay.
How?
I might have to modify this to make that a screenshot for the video.
Yeah.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, on that note, I think that's quite enough fun and games for tonight. So this is the great crash of Malay Junction, apparently. I'm pretty sure this has never happened before, ever.
No, I don't think it has.
Especially the engine sort of now bouncing around.
That's a hammer blow that you're talking about.
Oh yeah, it is. Okay, I'm going to stop it there. Yeah, thanks everyone for watching me sleep. thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Good night.
Night-night, guys.